first time in my 22 years, I began living in a room by myself. And more specifically, in a room not shared with Lou. And so, us sharing a room for 22 years, you really get to know a guy. And you see him develop from a unique vantage point. So that's kind of what I want to talk about tonight is there's a few characteristics that are very prominent in Luke's life that anybody can see. But the undergirdings that brought him to where he is, that's what I want to explain. Things that people may not know about. How we got to where he is, in a brief way. First, Luke is an orator. Luke speaks every week at the Cube on Wednesday night, preaching to our students. We all pretty well know that. But you may not know that he's been working on this skill for many, many years. Back to sharing a room, when we were in elementary school, oftentimes when we lay down at night to go to sleep, we would hear doo, doo, doo. Translation, our high school neighbor Donovan is playing basketball in the cul-de-sac by himself. He's playing in the dark at nighttime because he's not that good, but nobody really pays attention when it's dark outside. Nobody except for us, because our window faced the cul-de-sac, and those thuds would keep us awake. Too much energy as it was, Luke would break open the blinds and begin to commentate. Donovan, at the top of the key, shoots a three! Bridge! It was pretty funny and quite soothing. Helped me fall asleep a few nights. But he didn't just commentate down and play by himself. He did actual sporting events and also video games. One time, he came into the playroom. We were in Georgia, and Micah was pitching on a baseball career on MLB The Show. And Luke offers to commentate. He says, "Here, I'll turn down the volume." So he goes to turn it down against Micah's wishes. And the last thing we hear the game say before the volume goes off is Big Frank stepping up to the plate. So he turns the volume off. And this is when Luke thinks, now would be a great time for me to make my Babe Ruth-esque call your shot commentary moment by declaring, "Big Frank, home run." And sure enough, the next pitch, Mike had given up a long ball and swiftly rage quit. The point is, his voice is prophetic. It was even then. When he speaks, I recommend listening. He's in order. Luke is also a scholar. He's currently pursuing a master's degree from Southern Seminary, which most of us know. But I think it was probably when he was in middle school that I began to realize just how brilliant this guy is. In middle school, ever since middle school, we've had this running joke about Luke that he reads and memorizes the entire internet every single day. Because somehow, he's able to learn all the day-to-day news and remember it and form an opinion about it before most of us have even heard it. It's incredible. He knows more places and people than I could ever remember. And despite his commitment to memorizing the entire internet every day, he was still an incredible student. Furthermore, when he was in middle school, he had really bad allergies. And so during seasons with bad pollen in Georgia, which there were quite a few, and really bad, he would just take a Benadryl before going to school every single day. And as most of you may be aware, but what we didn't know at the time, the major side effect of Benadryl is drowsiness. And so, in other words, we were sending a drugged up in drowsy Lou to middle school every day. And by the way, he's got the whole internet racing through his head. And we're expecting him to learn. But not only did he learned well, and not just learned well, but receiving all A's, and not just receiving all A's, but being the rightful valedictorian of his class of several hundred students each and every year. And that is when I began to realize that even drugs cannot hold this man down. The drug just says nothing to him. And this dude is really, really bright. He's a smart man. Thank you, good sir. Lastly, I want to give one more characteristic. Luke is the leader. His nickname over the past decade, the one that's dominated, is the captain.
Captain!
Yeah. Crafted by NBA 2K11, but maintained by his leadership. The captain. And many of us know that Luke's led small groups, bands, most notably Burning Flame, of course. But he leads praise bands. Right now, he leads the youth group, and he assists Josh in leading the praise band, our youngest brother. And some of you are even familiar with the captain, so let's go back a little bit further, even back before 2011 when the captain began. Let's go all the way back to the cul-de-sac if we can. You see, when Donovan wasn't crowding out our space by playing basketball by himself in the cul-de-sac, sometimes our bike gang, which was me and my brothers and my neighbor Cameron, we would just chase each other endlessly in circles in the cul-de-sac on our bikes. Right? We called it NASCAR. We could do this for hours. We really did not get tired of it. Except for one day, we didn't get tired. And we decided, you know what, this territory is not quite enough for us. So we mopped our way to the back of the neighborhood, where we discovered an abandoned lot that had been dug out to have a basement, but they never really built on it. It was essentially a glorified pit. And so we get the bright idea, let's start dropping into this pit at the lower parts with our bikes and like build up some courage and confidence and anticipation of doing something crazy. Now, we didn't know what the crazy thing was at the time, but we just kept dropping in and building that confidence until Luke had offered this awesome suggestion. Hey, what if I take a bike and go up to the highest and the steepest part of this pit, and I drop in, but Joel, you can be on my pegs while I do this. Yeah, okay, so he was probably under the influence of some Benadryl. I don't know what the other side effects are, but something was really making him crazy. And he had to make a deal first with Cameron, actually, our neighbor. We didn't have a bike with pegs, so we had to work out this agreement. And the terms were something like this. Luke could borrow Cameron's bike with pegs, and Cameron would borrow Luke's Razor cell phone and dial 911 and hover his thumb over the green button, waiting to click save just in case, you know, like we fell and broke our bodies. That way emergency vehicles could respond in time. So anyway, we lined up at the highest and steepest part of this pit, and we're looking down into it, and I swear, if I could have been in his head, I'm sure the commentary went something like this. He begins pushing off, and they're rolling toward the pit now. Bikes beginning downward, and Joel's gripping for dear life. They're picking up speed, and wow, they level out and stick the landing. On that day, Luke and I realized our true evil Knievel by achieving glory in that dugout abandoned pit, and by flexing our bike gang's dominance over the rest of the neighborhood. This man is a leader, and he has been since way back when. His mind set on ambitious goals, his mouth ready to convince others to join him, and his hands firmly gripped on the handlebars, prepared to bring him across the finish line of whatever task he set out to accomplish. Luke is a leader. So when you look at Luke, you see his prominent characteristics. You see that he's an orator. You see he's a scholar. You see that he's a leader. I hope you have a deeper appreciation for the hard work he's contributed to becoming the man that he is today. And so for you, Luke, I'd like to say thank you for the incredible example you set for me and for the bros. We really appreciate it, and you're trailblazing the way for us. Super stoked for you and Melanie, one of the sweetest gals I've ever had. And can't wait to see how God's going to continue to use you guys for the ministry. So with that, if you have a lovely drink, I'd like to propose a toast here to Luke and Melanie.
Woohoo!
All right.
Meet your plate.